Get ready to experience living your best life with the catalyst of change and voice of hope to the nation's transformative leader and teacher life coach. Delivering a message of hope and encouragement is her purpose, to leading God's people from all walks of life, from a place of despair to a place of purpose and destiny. Dr. Veronica Simpson, a trailblazer for rising leaders, an uncompromising voice that God is using to stir up the body of Christ. Get ready to come up higher and discover what God is saying about your promise, your purpose, your personal journey of self-discovery to awaken your most dominant dreams and fulfill your purpose for life. So come on inside and prepare your heart and mind to receive direction to step into your divine destiny and live your best life with Dr. Veronica Simpson.
But if by chance he called me out, he called my name, I'm going out with a bang. I'm going out with a praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I don't know what you're going to do when you get to heaven. Hallelujah. But if you, we can't act like we act down here. Amen. Hallelujah. We can't act like we act down here, because the Bible said they praise him 24/7. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, ain't no time zone when you get to heaven. Hallelujah. Ain't no time zone when you get to heaven. You're going to be spiritually transformed. You're going to be a spirit, baby. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You ain't going to have no interruptions. Praise be to God. You ain't going to have no bills. You ain't going to have no sickness. You ain't going to have none of that. You ain't going to have to convince people that you're saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. You ain't going to have to convince people that you can sing and worship God. Amen. When we transition, all of this will be over. So that's why I praise him like I do. Come on and put your hands and give God praise for Prophetess Matt.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Come on, we can do better than that. You can do better than that. You're talking about a prophetic word, a prophet going forward. You know what I'm talking about? In the Old Testament, they say seers. Amen. Praise be to God. But you know what? You don't find too many prophets telling the truth now. So when one come along, sometimes it's hard to digest what they're saying. But I come to tell you tonight, hallelujah, that the woman of God, hallelujah, has a prophetic gift in the inside of her. And we thank God for last night.
Oh, yeah.
Evangelist Lisa Griffin, how she walked the house. I good God from Zion. Hallelujah, glory to God. And it's on Facebook. So if you want it, we'll tag you. But when you're talking about prophetically, yes. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. We give God the praise on this evening.
Yes.
You know
yes.
why? Because your season has a due date.
Yes. Come on. Yes.
Your season has a due date. Yes. Do you believe that?
Amen.
Do you really believe that?
Come on.
I don't care what anybody else has told you. Prophetically speaking, God told me your season has a due date.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Come on and put your hands together and give God praise. Yes. We're going to walk this word.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're going to walk the word. Hallelujah. Ezekiel 34 and 26. I just want to forerun for just a moment. Hallelujah. Glory to God. For Ezekiel 34 and 26 says, it says, and I will make them, God, and I will make them and the places all around my hill a blessing. Come on. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I will send down the showers in their season. Hallelujah. They shall be showers of blessings. I'm going to read that one more time so you can get it in your spirit. Amen. The word of the Lord says in Ezekiel, praise God, 34 and verse 26. It says, hallelujah, and I will, God himself, and I will make them and the places around them. God from Zion. My hill a blessing. And I will send down the showers in their season. And they shall know showers of blessing. Your season has a due date. And when you talk about seasons, I just want to talk for just a moment. When you talk about seasons, the word of the Lord says, as Evangelist Lisa said last night, and as Prophetess Mac said on tonight, to everything there's a season. Uh-huh. Hallelujah. For every activity under the heavens. Hallelujah. Ecclesiastes 3 and 1. And the word of the Lord says, when we see Ecclesiastes 3 and 1. Say Ecclesiastes 3 and 1.
Ecclesiastes 3 and 1.
When we see Ecclesiastes 3 and 1, what is that saying? What is that scripture talking about? What is that scripture declaring? I'll tell you what it's saying. Hallelujah. It's saying, it's putting forth a declaration. And it declares that for everything there is a season, meaning that the various circumstances, catch this, that the various circumstances we go through in life are not by accident.
Come on now.
But are orchestrated or allowed by God. That's what Ecclesiastes 3 and 1 says. Hallelujah. But then there's another powerful word, Galatians 6 and 9. I'm warming up here. Galatians 6 and 9. And let us not be weary.
Come on now.
In well doing. For in due season we shall reap if we not faint, or if we faint not. There is a due season to reap. And I know everything is going on around us. The news, hallelujah, is broadcasting what's going on, hallelujah, concerning this person and that person. Hallelujah, you hear news when you go to work. You hear news when you're in your home. You hear news all around you. When you go to church, you hear news. Praise be God. Sometimes it ain't the good news. Hallelujah. But we do have a season to reap. We have a season to reap. Because in due season means my time. For in due season means my time. It's your sowing that creates your harvest.
Yes.
It's your sowing that creates your harvest season. So we ask ourselves, is there really a due season to reap? I hear people saying, my season, it's my time. Hallelujah. God is getting ready to bless you in this era, in this season. Praise be to God. But you know what? There is a due season to reap. Praise be to God. And I believe we're in it. Hallelujah. So to reap, it means just don't get weary in well doing. Hallelujah. It means don't get tired or discouraged from continuing, watch this, to sow in the spirit. I'm just giving you some education. And I'm a ship. Can I say that again? Don't get tired. Say it with me. Don't get tired. On one accord. Don't get tired or discouraged. Yeah. From continuing
to sow
to the spirit. Encourage yourself
in
the Lord. When there is no one else around you to encourage you, what happens is that a stirring comes in your spirit. And hallelujah, the Greek word for do is idios. And hallelujah, God said to me, the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me, your season has a due date. And you're in it. And some of us don't even realize we're in it. But I'm going to talk about it. Look at your neighbor and say, it's time.
It's time.
Tell them again.
It's time.
Tell them again.
It's time.
Tell them like you believe it.
It's time.
Tell them like you mean it.
It's time.
Tell them like you mean it.
It's time.
Lay your hands on yourself.
It's time.
It's my time.
It's my time.
It's my due season. And all of the church shouted,
amen.
Hallelujah. You can take your seats. Turn with me to 2 Kings 4 and 16. Let's get busy. 2 Kings 4 and 16. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When you arrive there, please say, I am there.
I am there.
To just give you a full measure of what is taking place here in 2 Kings 4, the word of the Lord, let's go to verse 11. The word of the Lord says, and it happened. That's prophecy right there. That's revelation right there. And it happened one day that he came there. And he turned into the upper room and lay down there. Then he said to Gehazi, his servant, call this Shunammite woman. Praise God. When he had called her, she stood before him. And he said to her, and he said, when he had called her, she stood before him. And he said to him, say now to her, look, you have been concerned for us with all this care. What can I do for you? Good God. What can I do for you? Do you want me to speak on your behalf to the king or to the commander of the army? She answered, I dwell among my own people. So he said, what then is it to be done for her? And Gehazi answered, actually, she has no son and her husband is old. Catch what I'm saying. Hallelujah. Actually, she has no son and her husband is old. And the word of the Lord read in verse 15. So he said, call her. When he had called her, she stood in the doorway. Then he said about, good God, and I'm finna kick in right here. Verse 16. And he said to her, about this time next year, you shall embrace a son. And the word of the Lord says, and she said, no, my Lord. No, my Lord, man of God, do not lie to your maidservant. And the word of the Lord says, but the woman conceived.
Come on now.
But the woman conceived and bore a son when the appointed time had come.
Yes.
Of which Elijah had told her. And the child grew. And now it happened one day that he went out to his father, to the reapers. Mm-hmm. And he said to his father, my head. So he said to his servant, carry him to his mother. And when he had taken him and brought him to his mother, he sat down on her knees till noon and then died. I'm not going to focus on that part tonight, but I wanted to give you the full measure of it. And the word of the Lord says, and she said, no, my Lord. Man of God, do not lie to your maidservant. In other words, I've been wanting this a long time. I've been told this many times before. It never has came to pass as of yet. Come on now.
Come on.
But the word of the Lord says that it has to happen. Hallelujah. Look, it has to happen. It has to happen. It's not about who you are. It's not about where you live. It's not about where you're at. The word of God says, and it has to happen. And the word of the Lord says, and she said, no, my Lord, don't lie to your maidservant. Good God from Zion. Hallelujah. And the word of the Lord says, but the woman conceived. It's time. But the woman conceived and bore a son when the appointed time had come, of which Elijah had told her. Can we talk for just a few minutes? The Lord told me to tell you, it's time.
Thank you, Lord.
It's time. Let me tell you what the Lord said to me. The Lord said this to me. He said, when you have a due date, When you have a due date, this means that it's time to birth. When you have a due date, it's time to birth. Hallelujah. And the birthing is abnormal. I'm talking to ladies tonight. The birthing is abnormal. It is an abnormal transition. It is an abnormal transition. And the reason I say is a abnormal transition because the male cannot give birth. I don't care artificial insemination. I don't care. Hallelujah. The real deal is male cannot give birth in the natural. And so he said, because we as women can only give birth, which means, praise be to God, you're passing from the natural into the spiritual. Okay? So understand, it's an abnormal transition. It really is. It really is. When you tell somebody I'm birth, I'm carrying, it's so unreal that people will say, when you do, in the natural. I'm not talking about in the natural. I'm talking about in the spirit realm.
Yes, yes.
I'm talking about in the spirit realm. So the prophetic word, your season has a due date, is personal. It's personal. And at this moment in time, it's only for you.
Come on now.
That's right. Person. Come on.
Yes.
It's personal. Hallelujah. But let me tell you something. Can I tell you something?
Tell me.
In Luke 1 and 40 and 41, the word of the Lord says, where she entered the home of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped. Come on now. The baby leaped. Come on now. The baby leaped. Come on now. The baby leaped. She had not delivered yet, but the baby leaped in her womb. Hallelujah. God was letting her know it's alive, it ain't dead. I come to tell you tonight, it's alive, it ain't dead. I come to tell you tonight, praise be to God, in order for you to birth, hallelujah, this in walking this abnormal transition, hallelujah, you're going to have to find you a sister. You're going to have to find somebody that's in the word of God. You're going to have to find somebody that's seasoned. You're going to have to find somebody that can make your baby leap. You're going to have to find somebody that can remind you that you're still carrying, hallelujah, vision, that you're still carrying purpose. You're going to have to connect with somebody, and pretty much it ain't going to be who you think it is. Hallelujah, but you need to go on a search, hallelujah, and find the woman of God, or find the sister of God, or find the prophet of God, prophetess of God, or find, amen, the worshiper of God. Hallelujah, that when she enter the room, baby, hallelujah, your baby will leap. The vision inside of you will leap. Hallelujah, to let you know it ain't dead, it's yet alive.
Come on. Hallelujah.
It's your time. It's your time. And I don't know if you are really connected to somebody that can make your baby leap. If they come in your presence, and I'm talking about sisters, women, woman, if they come in your presence and all you feel is depression and despondent, hallelujah, you need to get away from them. Hallelujah. If they come in the room and they make you feel worse than what you are feeling at that particular time, you need to cut the ties. You need to cut the umbilical cord. You need to get away from them. You need to transition. Because I tell you, if you stay around her or them too long, what's on the inside of you, and it is a baby, hallelujah, in the spiritual realm, on the inside of you, it can kill your baby. Come on up in here. Hallelujah. Can I talk to the women for just a moment? Hallelujah. If you're around somebody and they're jealous of you, if you're around somebody and they say they like you but they really hate you, if you're around somebody that they always talking about them, it's always focused on them, that's a baby killer, baby. Hallelujah. That's somebody trying to take you to the abortion clinic. But what you need to understand is that you got to make a transition. You're going to have to leave my boo alone, my sister girl alone. You ain't gained nothing. You ain't getting nothing. You ain't gaining 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 nothing. You Holy Spirit. I'm just sitting, listen. I'm driving and he's speaking this to me. The Holy Spirit says, concerning your duty, first of all, you got to be in a relationship with another female. I don't care how you try to distance yourself and isolate yourself because you've been hurt, you've been wounded. There is a Mary.
Yes, come on. Yes,
come on.
Yes, come on now.
There is a Mary. There is a Mary. And your Mary may not be your little neighbor. Your Mary may not be the person you graduate college with. Your Mary may not be the one you went to school with. Your Mary may be in another state. Your Mary may be, hallelujah, traveling around the globe. Your Mary may be, hallelujah, in the critical ward, amen, waiting on you, praise be to God. Your Mary may be, hallelujah, I ain't playing with you, amen, hallelujah, and I'm getting ready to blow your mind. Your Mary may be the very woman that's walking up and down the street prostituting her body. Your Mary may be the very one, hallelujah, that's hitting dope, praise be to God. Your Mary, don't try to figure out who your Mary is. What you need to understand, when they come into your presence, do they make your baby leap?
Come on now.
Jesus.
Think about it. Pause. Selah. Do they make your baby leap? Or are they using you? No bullshit. Are they using you? Are they using the gift that's on the inside of you?
Come on now.
Are they prostituting your gift? Hallelujah. When they get around you, all they talk about is who they are, what they're doing.
My God.
You know what I'm saying? It's all about them. It's all about them. And let me tell you another point. If you've been around them for years and you ain't growing, and you ain't growing, and you are not growing spiritually, you need to click, 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 click. Because there is a Mary. There is a Mary. And sometimes you got to wait on God and go through a search of people.
That's right.
Just like when the boys were being chosen, and the prophet said, wait a minute, do you have any more sons? Yes, he's over there shoveling boo-boo. Bring him. That's the one. He had to have insight on what God was saying to him, because he didn't look like he was birthing anything. David, but God. But let's go back to this woman. She conceived, and we know a tragedy.
Yeah.
You've been listening to Living Your Best Life with the in-depth life application principles and teachings with Dr. Veronica Simpson. We pray that you've been blessed by this timely word of encouragement and insightful teachings as you prepare to step into this new season and live your best life. Visit Dr. Veronica Simpson at drvsimpson.com. That's drvsimpson.com. On Facebook at Veronica H. Simpson. Instagram at Hazel Simpson 316. On YouTube, Pastor Veronica Simpson. Speaker, advocate, author, and educator sought after empowerment, veteran, revisionist thinker, and a transformative leader that possesses a mantle to meet the needs of everyone. Dr. VS would love to host your next event, workshop, or conference. Contact her at veronicasimpson59@yahoo.com. That's veronicasimpson59@yahoo.com for more details.